Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here, and in this video, I'm going to show you how switches work in C++. Let's get into it. A switch is basically a bunch of consecutive if statements. However, using a switch is much more efficient. You could say that it's harder, better, faster, stronger. So here's an example of when we might want to use a switch in place of a bunch of if statements. Let's write a program where we can enter a number between 1 and 12, and it will give us a corresponding month depending on the number that we type in. So before we get this started, let's just include one thing. We're going to type include, then a set of angle brackets, and then we're going to type in string. All right, let's create a integer named month. And we will not assign this a value right away. We'll just declare it. And let's create a prompt to ask for a month. Enter the month. Then we'll put the numbers 1 through 12 here. I think I'm going to get rid of that colon. All right. And then we are going to use cin month. I finished typing everything. So here's what you don't want to do. Writing an if statement and then writing an if statement or an else if statement right after. And it's going to check if month is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on and so forth all the way till 12. So if a veteran programmer sees you do something like this where you write a bunch of consecutive if statements, they're probably going to call you a noob. And there's a better option, and that's by using this thing called a switch. This is how you write one. We're going to type switch. Then we need an expression, or we can stick a variable within here. So we want to check the month. And then we need a set of curly brackets. In place of if statements, we use cases, and we're going to check if our value is equal to some case. And the first thing we'll want to check if our case is equal to 1. So we're going to type in case 1 colon, and then on the next line, we're going to type cout, it is January. And then this step is important too. We're going to type break. So if this case matches what we want to evaluate or check, we're going to do this and then break out of the switch, and we don't need to check anything else. So we're going to do the same thing for case 2. So case 2, then we want our program to do this, display, it is February, and then break. All right, but you get the idea. I'm going to repeat this process for cases 3 through 12, so I'll just fast forward this video. All right, it's done. So we have cases 1 through 12, one corresponding to each month of the year. So let's test out this program. Enter the month. Well, currently it is April, so I'm going to type 4 and hit enter. So 4, enter. And it says it is April. Let's try a different month. I'm going to type in 12, hit enter, and it says it is December. So we know the switch is working. What happens if we type in a number that doesn't match any of these cases? Well, let's see what happens. So it says enter the month. I'm going to type in the word pizza. So nothing appears to happen. So what we can do is that we can place a default case. What do we want our switch to do by default in case there are no matching cases? So we're going to write default at the end. And what do we want our program to do? So first, make sure you write default and then add a colon at the end. And let's simply display a message that says, you did not enter a number between 1 and 12. Enter the month. It is pizza month. You did not enter a number between 1 and 12. So it's similar to an else statement where it's like a last resort if there are no matching cases. We'll have our program do this by default. So how this works is that the switch expression is evaluated at once and selects one of these many code blocks depending if there's a matching case or not. If there's no matching case, we can execute whatever is within the default code block. Now with these break keywords, these are important to have after each case, and if you were to take these out, we would continue on to the next case as if the next case was also true. So let's try this program again and take out a few of these breaks and see what happens. Enter the month. It is April, so I'm going to type in the number 4 and hit enter. And our result is, it is April, it is May, it is June, it is July, it is August. So if you're missing a break within a case, it's going to continue on to the next case as if that next case was also true, and it's not going to stop until it reaches a break. And these cases don't necessarily have to be numbers. Let's try another example using char values, characters. I have an idea. Let's write a program that will ask for a letter grade, like in school, the letters A through F, and we will give a response based on what letter grade that we answer with. So to begin, let's create a variable that will store a single character, a char value, and we will say answer, and we don't need to assign this a value right away. Next, we will say cout. This will function as a prompt. What letter grade did you get? And perhaps I'll just put A through F in here. And then we will say cin answer. Let's create a switch. So switch. Then this part's the expression. We'll just put our answer within here. And we will check this answer against many different cases. In our first case, instead of 1, we're going to type in A within single quotes. So if our answer matches this case, where it's A, the character A, what do we want our program to do? Perhaps a simple message such as, you did perfect. And then we want to break. All right, let's repeat the same process for the other letter grades. So case B. What do we want our program to do if this case matches? You did good. And then break. And it's just a matter of repeating the same process for each of these letter grades. So case C. C out. You did okay. And break. Case D, C out, you did not do so good. It's still passing though. And case F, C out, you failed. And break. We can add a default code block, so let's do that. We're going to type in default, and we will display a message. Enter a letter grade, A through F. Oh, I guess we're missing E, but who cares? Let's run this program and see if it actually works. What letter grade did you get? I got an A. So I typed an A, hit enter. You did perfect. All right, we got an A, everybody. What letter grade did you get? I got an F. You failed. Have a nice day. All right, then let's type in something that's not a letter grade, like the word pizza. And we get that default message of enter a letter grade A through F. So we know the switch is working. But yeah, you're not limited to just using numbers for your cases. You can also use characters and other things too. So just to summarize what we did here today, a switch is more efficient than using a bunch of consecutive if statements. We can take a value or expression and compare it to see if it's equal against many cases at once. If there is a matching case, we can activate the corresponding code block and have our program do something that we specify, and then we can use the break keyword to break out of the switch and continue on with the rest of the program. And we can also add a default code block if there are no matching cases, we can have our program do something by default. But yeah, that's the basics. If you want a copy of the examples that we worked on today, I'll post it in the comments down below and pin it to the top. And if you're looking for practice or a project to work on, why don't you create your own switch and then post it in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of how switches work in C++. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.